welcome back. And if you joined us late today, my special guest is Senator Larry Martin, South Carolina Senator, and we're honored to have him here. Now, we've talked about the violence, and we're going to get to work on that, but let's talk about the roads. Everybody's concerned about the roads in South Carolina.
It is a really hot topic, and it's embarrassing that our roads have gotten in the condition they're in, and that's an issue we will take up in the Senate. The House is working on that right now, and trying to get a bill over to us. In the meantime, we're working on domestic violence, on ethics, on other the DUI legislation that we've introduced. We'll get the highway funding bill a little bit later in the session, and they'll also send us the budget where we'll deal with education and all
that.
So
you have to wait until they send it to you before you can really take it up and do any kind of action on it.
We do. Anything that deals with revenue needs to start over in the House.
All right. Now, let's talk about ethics. Okay.
Ethics has been an issue ever since I've been in the General Assembly. And when I was in the House back in the 80s, I saw a number of my colleagues get in trouble. In the late 80s, early 90s, we had Operation Lost Trust. And then I moved to the Senate. We're still having trouble. Had a House Speaker that got into big trouble last year, Lieutenant Governor prior to him. So there needs to be a change in the way we handle complaints on legislators. And what I've tried to do is the serious complaints needs to go to an independent outside group to investigate allegations of misconduct involving the ethics or the campaign laws. And I've just had real trouble getting that through. We had a bill, Senate Bill 1, that I got out very early. And just this week, we pretty much skidded off the road, so to speak, to second reading on it, because the opposition insisted that sitting members of the legislature had to be on this independent commission to investigate us.
So you investigate yourself, in
That's
other
exactly.
words.
We're a special class of people. No. So I told the Senate, I said, if you adopt this amendment, you're going to put me in a position of having to vote against my own bill, which I ultimately did. They adopted the amendment, and I voted against the bill. We moved to reconsider the vote yesterday before we left, and the governor is doing her best to twist some arms and change some people's position on that. We had some here in the upstate that didn't vote with us, and some other areas around the state, and my hope is that we will change enough minds that we can take this bill back up in a few weeks and put an independent group, totally unconnected to the legislature, in charge of investigating serious allegations of violations of the law. And now, when it comes to rules, we've got our internal ethics committees, and the Constitution requires us to discipline our members pursuant to our rules. But I'm talking about the ethics laws, the same thing that the governor runs under, lieutenant governor, the constitutional officers, county council, school boards, the laws that we passed, we don't allow them to be enforced on us the same way, unless it gets to the attorney general like it did on the speaker last year, and he can go to a grand jury and indict you.
So what you're trying to do, and some other people are trying to do, is it's kind of like asking a child who's been bad to spank themselves.
Yeah, or decide if
you
they need a spanking.
You want an outside group that's not a member of the Senate or the House to look at all the charges and interview whatever and do what is necessary.
Well, if it's a technical violation, such as, you know, your campaign report haven't been signed properly, there's something that's been inadvertently left off, and you amend it, and you self-report that, well, that's what we call a technical violation. And we don't need to, there seems to be a big concern that if we turn this over to an outside group, that it's just going to be one embarrassing
It'll be political.
Yeah, and it'd be very political, yeah. Witch hunt kind of thing. I don't think so. We'd still appoint folks to it that would actually serve on it, but we couldn't discuss anything with them, and there would have to be a wall between us and them.
And you're talking about big stuff, like
I'm talking
like
about stealing,
people using yeah. campaign funds for their own benefit,
stealing,
and things like that.
Theft, putting yeah. cash in your pocket,
yeah.
Cooking the books, whatever it is that
I mean,
is that's, egregious.
That's big things.
Yeah,
and that's what you're trying to address.
That need, and I told the Senate, I said, I can't for the life of me understand why any of us would want to give the public the impression that we got a problem with some outside group looking at that, if that indeed, if a probable cause finding is made that we've done engaged in that kind of conduct. But I was outvoted this week and consequently voted against my own bill.
So what's going to happen to the ethics?
Well, my hope is that there will be enough people who will change their minds. You know, one of the things that said repeatedly, Peggy, nobody said anything to me about this. Nobody said anything to me about the ethics law and how we operate. Well, I got news for them. I don't operate off just what somebody said to me recently. You're supposed to have some core convictions about certain things. And, you know, now that I'm in a position to do something about it as chairman of the Judiciary Committee, I've been trying now for 3 years to get this done, and I'm bound and determined to keep trying. But I need some votes. I need some people to go along with me in doing that.
How important is it for just everyday people like me and you out there, how important is it for us to call up our representatives and say, you need to know about this. I don't want you to vote for that. We need this bill on the books. We need to change our laws in South Carolina. Do you want to hear from people?
We do, and people like me pay attention to that. We really do. And
so if you get one or two phone calls, you'll say, well, that's some, you know, that's
you
not
get
important.
Several.
But if you get 15 phone calls, the flag goes up.
It does.
Am I right?
Exactly.
Yeah.
And the website is very easy to access our email. What I encourage people to do, it is so easy to email us. And usually it's our name at SC Senate or SC House.
So you just say Larry Martin at SC Senate.
.gov,
and that's it.
And that
it.
Gets right to me.
Yeah, okay.
And if it doesn't go that way, you know, you remember, if it's like in Greenville, Mike Fair at SC Senate, or, you know, Ross Turner at SC Senate.
All right.
If it doesn't go that way, go to the website, and it'll get it exact for you.
Now, I have something else I want to bring up. I want to talk about our DUI laws.
Oh, yes.
And we have very bad problems on the roads in South Carolina. Not that they have potholes, but that we don't drive according to the rules. And
irresponsible.
You're all right if you're over 21, you can drink, and you're not breaking the law. But when you get behind the wheel of a car,
you don't need to be impaired.
That's it.
And
where do you draw the line? How do we every day it seems like you pick up the paper and there's been another death on the highway.
We passed a bill 2007-2008 that required law enforcement officers to videotape suspects in doing their field sobriety test. What we didn't intend is for that law to be used by the defense attorneys in such a way so as to get cases thrown out when the evidence is shown in court. They say, well, you can't see the guy's feet behind the hood of the car, and it's midnight, dark.
Or there's a shadow. And so
Or you might not even be able to see the person's head very well, but you can see him stumbling around, and plenty of evidence of a drunk driver. So We're attempting to deal with that.
Because that is left to the police officer to make that photograph. Am I right?
Well, the video.
Yeah, I mean the video.
Right.
Yeah.
And the way you do that, your video camera's running. You're in front of the car, but naturally the car hood is going to obscure, particularly when the suspect gets close to the front of the car. So they've ruled courts have ruled that if the body goes out of range of the video at any point in time, then that video evidence is no good.
Yeah, and of course, some of these attorneys who make a fortune defending people.
And I'm all about people's rights.
They have rights,
but still, that's ridiculous. I mean, it's almost akin, Peggy, to requiring, and there's discussion about body cameras on law enforcement officers.
Yeah.
But you can rest assured, this fellow, any law that is written will have a disclaimer written in it that if body cameras are required for police officers, you know, as we can afford to pay for them, and I think there's a lot of benefit to that, and a lot of agencies around have them. But I am intent on making sure that nothing about that body camera requirement will invalidate an otherwise lawful arrest.
Okay.
Because we've seen it with the DUI law, which we're trying to change right now. Cases have been thrown out. Wouldn't it be awful if an apprehended suspect is tossed out, and he's just robbed a convenience store, the officer runs him down, he arrests him, put the cuffs on him, and the defense lawyer says, well, where's your body camera evidence? I said, well, the camera broke as I was arresting this guy.
Mm-hmm.
Judge, you're going to have to dismiss the case. You don't have the body camera evidence.
Yeah.
So we can't have that. So
you're against this idea, and we're almost out of time, of having to have a photograph, a video.
I'm fine with body cameras because I think that can vindicate law enforcement in many respects. And Lord knows we don't need for law enforcement to be mistreating minorities.
No, not anyone. Everybody has a right.
Exactly, or anybody for that matter. But, you know, by the same token, they're not going to talk this country boy from Pickens into signing off on a bill that's going to allow them to get defendants who are guilty, otherwise guilty of crimes, off.
Okay.
So we'll fix that.
I'm with you. We're out of time. Senator Larry Martin, bless you. Thank you. Keep up the good work.
Thank you.
Remember, we have a right to be heard, so call your representatives. Bye-bye.